Hi, welcome to Enchiridion. Gerrothorax was a temnospondyl amphibian from the Triassic period of Greenland, Germany, Sweden, and possibly even Thailand. Gerrothorax was unusual among ancient amphibians because it retained its feathery gills throughout its adult life. In other amphibians, the gills were lost as the animals matured from the larval stage to their adult stage, thus they retained their larval stage gills. This is called neoteny. These gills were located directly behind the head and arranged into three pairs. These gills are known to be a permanent feature of adult animals due to the fact that they were actually supported by bone. It is possible that the gills were sometimes placed behind the broad head to protect them from damage and hide them from view. Due to these gills, Gerrothorax was able to survive in water with lower oxygen levels. They may have also helped Gerrothorax to be as big as it was, a meter in length. As despite the fact that amphibians absorb oxygen through their skin, the lower body would have been in regular contact with the bottom of its environment. This contact restricted the even flow of water over its body and the presence of features for the purpose of camouflage and protection that hampered its ability to process oxygen from above, were all factors that necessitated the presence of external gills. Gerrothorax, which looked like a big tadpole with a flattened body, was able to breathe underwater using its gills. Its body is flattened to the extreme, and is one of the morphological features that suggests that Gerrothorax lived at the bottom of aquatic habitats, like rivers and lakes. It had a wide head, on the top of which were its eyes, set close together. Its eyes are placed on top of the head in an orientation that would allow upwards vision. Gerrothorax seems to have used this vision to find prey that were swimming above. It may have rested on the bed of a lake or a river, looking up through the water for a passing fish, and when one came close enough, it ambushed it. Living at the bottom may make it hard for any animal to open their lower jaw without scraping the bottom. Gerrothorax avoided this by tilting its head and opening its upper jaw instead. They also may have used lures to attract prey. Thus, Gerrothorax possibly had at least camouflage patterning across its body to allow it to blend in with the bottom, something that hid it from prey and possible predators. Its mouth was probably camouflaged, yet it also had a brightly colored lure, which Gerrothorax could use to great effect by moving it around and making it look like a worm, which would then attract the attention of prey, fish, and smaller amphibians. As prey came closer and closer, Gerrothorax brought its upper jaw down to trap its prey. There are currently no fossils that confirm the presence of a lure in Gerrothorax, yet this hunting strategy can be observed nowadays in the alligator snapping turtle, which is a brightly colored appendage that looks like a worm on the tip of its tongue. It may have used this lure and quickly snapped its jaws like this turtle. Gerrothorax means plated chest or wicker chest. It was named by Nilsson in 1934. Species include G. radicus, which is the type species, and G. pocheramus. It was a carnivore, and it reached up to 3 feet and 3 inches in length. It has been found in Europe and Scandinavia, specifically in Germany, Greenland, and Sweden. It lived during the Norian of the Triassic 210 million years ago, and fossil representation includes a multiplicity of individuals. And with that, thank you for watching this program episode of Prehistoric Beast as a short fact-based episode. This is Enchiridion, see you next time.